Hi, I'm Steve. Welcome to the Arc Academy. Right now what I'm doing is I'm in the process of making a table for a Christmas present for my lady. And one mantra that we always use in our classes at Arc Academy is cut, prep, tack, weld. So before you cut, you want to make sure your measurements are accurate. So whatever you're going to be using, today we're making a coffee table for her, and she has very specific dimensions that she wants to use, so I'm using those dimensions. So I've already got my frame outs done, and I have to finish up chopping up the material for the legs. So let's go do that. So we just got done with the cutting, and essentially what you want to do when you are cutting is measure everything out, then you want to cut it. When you have an existing piece of glass, we just took a piece of glass out of stock here in the shop. When you have an existing piece of glass, obviously you want to measure the edges of the glass and be as accurate as you can. When you already have the piece of glass, make sure you frame out around the glass. What I did is single miter cuts for my frame out, and then I did straight cuts for all the other pieces. You want to cut everything out first. Have all your parts in place, measured out, make sure everything's even and consistent before you move forward. Cut, prep, tack, weld. Next stage is our prep. So we're gonna do a light surface prep in all the areas that we will be welding, and we wanna take off all the burrs off of our material. So we're gonna use, I have a 60 grit flap disc on here right now, which should work just fine for that. And let's get to it. So going back to our mantra, cut, prep, tack, weld, what we wanna do is we're gonna take that existing piece of glass and we're gonna just check our measurements and make sure our frame out is accurate and square and flush. So we put the glass into our holder. We have some magnetic squares in here that are holding our 90 degree square positions. And as we look through it, we just see about a 16th of an inch of light in between our frame out and our glass, which is perfect for what we wanna do. Now, you never want to weld with the glass in place, okay? Glass will break apart, explode, or you can just, you know, burn the glass and it won't look pretty when you put the glass in place on your coffee table. So what we're gonna be doing to tack this frame together is we're gonna be using the Millermatic 211 set to the appropriate, I do believe this is 14 gauge steel. For me personally, I like to set just a hair high so I can get good deep penetration on my tacks going further. So we're gonna start by tacking on the outsides, then the insides, and then we're gonna check and make sure it's squared up once again. So we got all our tacks done, and we used a MIG process for tack, and now we're gonna move on to TIG welding for actually welding the piece together. But before you do, what you wanna do is you wanna go through, check all your measurements, check, make sure everything's square, make sure it's level. Best thing to do is put it on the most level surface you possibly can and make sure it's not wobbling. If it's wobbling, that means one leg's off and you got a little bit more grinding work to do. But besides that, what we're doing is we've already squared up everything. It's level and ready to go. So what I wanna do is we're using the Diversion 180 today to weld up this frame with, and this is 14 gauge. So 14 gauge is 0.074 yada, yada, yada inches. So what we wanna do is we wanna set our welder for at minimum 74 amps. I personally like to set it a little high and then taper down while I'm welding. So I'm gonna set it to right about 78 to 80 for 14 gauge. Then I start hot and then I gradually take my foot off the pedal as I'm welding. But that's a personal preference. A lot of people will go right to 75 and maintain that the entire time. So we're just gonna start by flipping this guy over and doing the interior underneath on the supports first. So we're gonna weld right in here, here, going in a cross pattern, and there it is. So we'll get going. So now that we got everything welded together, everything's in place, it's pretty much secured now, we want to make the recess, or what I refer to as the bedding, for the glass to recede into. Now we have 1 inch square tube, we got half inch glass thickness, and then, so what we're going to do is we're going to use half inch square bar for our bedding. And then, of course, it's half, everything's half inch, so your half inch spacer is also a half inch. So we just rest this on top of a half inch square bar, and then we're gonna clamp this and weld this into place. We're gonna tack at the ends first to secure it into place, then we're gonna clamp, and everywhere I have prepped the material, we're gonna put two tacks, and then we're going to connect the two tacks together. So there you have it. Very simple 1 inch square tube coffee table. I'm probably going to just clean it up and finish it off with a matte clear coat and probably have an oak bottom. And I'll probably stain the oak bottom some kind of darker cherry or espresso colors. So if you're new to metal fabrication and welding, you can go to arcacademy.com. We have an entire video curriculum that you can check out with all sorts of pointers and tips and how-tos on how to make a coffee table just like this. If you're in the Chicagoland area, look us up because we have Fabrication 101 table making classes, MIG welding classes, and TIG welding classes. So thank you for watching, and go ahead and check us out at arcacademy.com.